One community, one webs VLC. United and brave as healing and brighter future begins. COVID-19, coronavirus, pandemic, social distancing, quarantine, face mask, distance learning, and lockdown. These are just few of the words that became famous and are almost used on a daily basis for the past 2 years. The world has come into an awkward standstill 2 years ago when the COVID-19 pandemic rose from the depths of oblivion and made its way into the world, unleashing its deadly talents in everything that crosses its path, crippling businesses, every nation's economy, tourism, education, and sending healthcare workers in every part of the globe to overwork and overexhaust themselves to combat this monstrosity. People were told to stay at home for their safety. Quarantine restrictions were enforced and minimum health protocols were observed to prevent the spread of the virus. Because of this unforeseeable ordeal, academic institutions around the world were forced to modify their ways and means of learning. Classrooms, chalkboards, scientific laboratories, armchairs, and the imposing and academic ambience a school brings to students were replaced with laptops, desktops, Wi-Fi, smartphones, and modules, and the more laid-back, cozy setting a home can offer. Here in the Philippines, particularly here in the West Visayas State University Lambuno campus, when the news came out that classes will be suspended for 2 to 3 weeks, we, the students, were filled with hope. All will be back to normal within a few weeks. It turned out that face-to-face classes may be gone for good, and almost 3 years from the fateful news in class suspension, here we all are, trenching our way into the new normal, and coping up in various ways to keep our sanity, dreams, and determination to finish school alive. Throughout our transition into the new normal, an adjustment to distance learning, I have sensed that besides the distance that separates students, the lingering issue of social stratification can be totally felt. Privileged, well-off students have access to almost anything: speedy internet connection, premium accounts on academic sites, and they don't have necessarily to leave their homes, whereas less privileged students have to scour their way to places with better signal, enduring bad weather, muddy terrain, and lagging cell phones, just to attend their classes. Teachers too face the same dilemma. They too were thrust into this blended learning quite unprepared and have to abandon the usual or conventional type of learning and have to make do with everything just to impart what they have learned to the students. Education, nowadays so it seems, is not for the sake of learning anymore, but merely for the sake of compliance and passing. This hindrances, however, quite defacing the educational system, nevertheless made a tougher and evolved person out of students, that despite the distance, these students can still learn something. They have learned to become one in pursuing academic excellence in the midst of crisis, one in helping their fellow students who are less privileged, and one in making their aspirations come true, no matter how elusive it might be. Through the efforts of our servant leaders, the student body are able to come together through various activities, and students are able to enjoy and take a break from their usual routine, which can be quite draining. The present administration of the West Visayas State system also heard the cries of our fellow students who are struggling in this blended learning and decided to give wellness break to students and faculty and staff every semester to take good care of their mental health. Beside unity, this blended learning pushed the students of WebS2LC to become braver individuals as we hurdled through our daily lives. Setting aside our fears of contracting the virus and become afflicted, and somehow still finding ways to cope up with the situation and be able to submit works on time. Healing. This is what the world needs right now, and somehow we are almost there to that phase. The threat of the new Omicron variant looms ahead, but it does not wrench the spirits of students as we are anticipating for the reopening of limited classes next year. And in the light of this new hope, we might be seeing a light at the end of the tunnel, that at last we will be able to see each other again in the future and come together and strive for excellence within the walls of the institution, that at long last there is a brighter future ahead for our students. How long to see the day when we all see each other again in school. And here's to healing and a brighter future for us united and braver students of the West Visayas State Lambuno campus.